Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and I want to welcome you back to our weekly video series. Today, we're going to talk about two things. We're going to talk about Kaarel Moppel's post on how to generate lots of test data with Postgres using PGBENCH to load data fast and faster. And we're going to talk about the new RandomNormal function that was recently added to Postgres 16. This blog post, Kaarel describes how to generate a lot of data for testing your disks or testing some of the database configuration or doing other kinds of tests in Postgres. Kaarel points out you may want to do that if you're trying to understand what happens when your data doesn't fit into RAM anymore. You might want to do things like explain DDL operations. What happens if I create a table and then alter column? Is the alter column going to rewrite the table? Is it going to be slow or is it going to be fast because Postgres does not do a table rewrite? You maybe also want to test your low on disk alerting setup. You might want to do things like testing your block latency or looking at your I/O schedule configuration. These are the reasons why you may want to have a large table to test with. The simplest way of just generating a bunch of data is to use generate series. We'll actually come back to generate series at the end today, but generate series is just very useful. For example, we generate 30 million rows, which roughly is 1 gigabyte table, within a few seconds. If you want to get something more interesting with at least a handful of table, PGBENCH is a great way to do that. The rest of the article here is an introduction to the different PGBENCH initialization options. We'll start with just the scale factor, which says how large should the test data set be. One scale factor unit equals 100,000 banking schema account rows. The banking schema is the benchmark schema example that is used by PGBENCH. If you multiply it by 5,000, it roughly generates 73 gigabytes of data. There is ways to calculate if I need 100 gigabytes of data, which scale factor I need, but for now, we'll just use 5,000 as a scale factor. In this test example, doing that takes 870 seconds to load that data into the Postgres database. Oftentimes, when you're doing tests like this, you don't necessarily need the data to be persisted. And oftentimes, the whole wall logging process in Postgres will slow things down and will skew your tests. Postgres has a concept of unlocked tables. Unlocked tables are not wall archived. They're not crash safe, and they're also not replicated to replica. But they are very useful, and they're actually more useful than temporary tables because they are visible to all the users on the database server. They get auto-vacuumed and auto-analyzed, and they don't bloat the Postgres catalog as much. Another thing we can do, if we're doing a test and we just care about the table having a bunch of data, we can modify the PGBENCH in its phase options. You can say what PGBENCH should do in the initialization phase. By default, it will do all of them. It would do D for dropping the existing tables, T for creating new tables, G for generating data, V for vacuum, P for primary keys, F for foreign keys. Oftentimes, you may want to skip P or F to not have indexes at all, and Kaarel also skips the vacuum option. And this gave us a huge performance boost here because indexes are expensive, a 3x improvement just in terms of data load time. If you just want the data, this is a great way of doing that. Let's say we really just care about benchmarking I/O. We want to see how good or bad the I/O subsystem of our server is. We can use the fill factor setting in Postgres to say in each page on the table, how much data should be in that page. By default on the table, that will be 100%. Postgres will try to get as much data as possible into a single data page. But with the fill factor option, we can say only do 10%. If we just care about generating some I/O, this is a good option. There's various other ways to speed this up. One thing that I found interesting here at the end is Kaarel also describes a strategy to utilize the partitions option in PGBENCH to generate the data not all into one big table, but actually having a partition table and then having clients work on different tables in parallel, inserting into the table itself. It generates a bunch of test data first and then keeps inserting that data into itself. That keeps the work somewhat separate and lets you stress the I/O even more on the system and see where it fails first. Now, the other thing I wanted to mention is a new feature in Postgres 16. This is a new function called RandomNormal. It lets us generate a random value that's not completely random, but it actually is along a normal distribution. We can use that to generate what looks like a normal curve. You can imagine if you're trying to model a certain type of data set, then being able to use this whilst not actually using the same values all over again will be quite useful in Postgres 16 for generating test data. I hope this upcoming year we'll see lots of benchmarking and your Postgres databases continue to perform well. I wish you a happy new year. And thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.